Hey there, welcome to WP Beginner and thanks for tuning in. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can fix the WordPress not sending emails issue. If you use a form on your site, say like Gravity Forms or WP Forms, then you need to rely on your website for sending emails. And a lot of times if your site isn't sending emails, it's because your hosting provider, they don't have the PHP mail function turned on the server. And that's okay. We actually recommend that you use SMTP for sending email. That is the Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, and it's the industry standard for sending emails. To get that going on your site, I'm going to walk you through in this video how to set up a MailGun account and how to connect that to your website so that you know that your emails are getting sent on your website. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and go to MailGun and we want to sign up. The service is quite affordable. The first 10,000 emails a month are free. So I'm going to go ahead and create an account real quick and then we'll move on. Once you create an account, you're going to see this area and you want to just scroll down because we're going to add your domain here. I'm going to click Add Domain. From here, we need to add a subdomain. We'll create the subdomain on our website host platform. So I'm going to keep this open. We're going to create the subdomain and that is going to be on our own hosting site. So what we need to do is go ahead and keep this page open, but we need to go to our hosting account, log into the cPanel, and we're going to scroll down and we're looking for the subdomains area. From here, I'm going to click on the subdomains because I want to create one. And see, this is the one I want to use. If you have multiple domains, you want to pick the one that you want to use this for. And I'm going to type mail1. So it's basically going to be mail1.midomain. Right, now that we created that, I'm going to copy that information, go back to MailGun. I want to add that subdomain here, and then click Add Domain. Okay, now we need to go through and do some verification. What it's saying here is you need to go to the DNS provider. So again, you need to go back to your hosting account, go to the home area. And this time we want to go into advanced DNS zones area to set this up. There are two records that we want to enter, this text one and this text one. So we want to enter this value and this information on our advanced DNS area. Okay. So first thing I'm going to do is copy this info, add it into the name area. The time to live, we're going to put the default 14.4. This is a text type. And the address, I'm going to come over back over here, copy that value, add it here, and add record. All right, successfully added, and we can see it down here. We need to do the same thing for the other one. I'm going to copy this information. Add that to the name area. I'm going to grab this whole piece, add it to the address. The time to live is the default. The type is text, and I'm going to paste that data there. And I want to add that record as well. All right, that one was added successfully as well. All right, now that I have entered that, I need to go back to my cPanel homepage, and I need to make an entry. I'm looking for the MX record entry because I need to make an MX entry. From here, I need to choose the root domain and I want to add what I see here. So it's a 10 priority and this value. So do 10. The destination will be that. Add the new record. All right, now we've added everything that we need to the hosting side. So now we need to go to our actual WordPress website. Go ahead and log in. Under plugins, we want to add new. And we're searching for the plugin called MailGun for WordPress. So we hit enter. And this is the one we want from MailGun. So we'll install now. And we want to activate it. All right, once it's activated, we need to go into settings. And we want to go ahead and set all of this up. Yeah, we want to use the HTTP API setting. That's the default, and that's perfect for what we're doing. The MailGun domain name, you want to go over to your MailGun site and copy this domain up here. put that there. And then you also want to grab your API key from your MailGun site, put that here. Here you can decide if you want to choose to track your clicks and the open rates of the emails. You can also add a tag for further tracking and analytics. And then here's the short code for later. But we want to just save the settings. And then we want to test configuration, make sure everything looks okay. And now what we have is success. And with that, we've fixed the issue of not being able to send emails from our WordPress website. If you like this video, click on the like button and go ahead and leave us a comment there. We'd love to hear from you. And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest videos.